Yes, here's another DM7 series training video. We've been working through split mode, assist, user preferences, and bus setup. Now, let's take a deeper look in the patch menu. Both DM7 and DM7 Compact provide a huge number of input and output connections in their small frame sizes, including either 32 or 16 omni inputs, 16 omni outputs, 18 in and out via USB, 64 in and out via the PY card slot, and 144 in and out via Dante. So it's important to understand what's happening in the patch grids. Let's begin with the input channel patch. Use the patch icon at the top of the screen. Select input channel, and there are three ways to view the information: list, grid, or universe. Let's start with the list screen because it shows the most amount of information per channel. See, each input channel has two patches available. Input A is set by default with input B blank. It can be set up with alternative inputs to use in a backup or emergency situation, or just to switch between different microphones quickly. Touch a box to see the patching options. Scroll down to see that effects returns can be patched. Even output channels can be patched back to inputs in case you have an unusual routing need. Select the input port for the patch you wish to make. One input port can be patched to multiple input channels. Notice the sequential patch feature. If you wish to patch USB ports 1 to 16 to input B for channels 1 to 16, this makes it simple. Touch the input B box for channel 1, touch the sequential patch number and enter 16. Touch USB 1 to indicate the start of the sequence, and touch OK to proceed with the patch operation. Now scroll down the list to confirm it's correct. You can also use a sequential patch to clear a range of patches. This list screen is a good place to make any direct out patches and set the pickoff point. Notice the convenient Set All shortcut. This can be useful for sharing the inputs with another mixer or a multi-track recorder. Though if you are intending to make any virtual sound checks, it would be best to use the separate recording patch instead. More about that in a later video. You can see all the input insert information here, though I think it's better to make the plug-in insert patching elsewhere after deciding which premium rack and other items you wish to use. I recommend to manage that in the rack menu. Let's move to the grid view. Here you see input channels arranged vertically and input ports listed horizontally. Touch a square to make the patch. either for the A inputs or the B inputs. Touch the continuous patch button at the top left of the grid to start making a sequential patch. Keep rotating the touch and turn knob for as long as you'd like to keep the patch sequence going. Touch the tick to confirm or the X to cancel. Because this grid is so large, it takes time to scroll from one side to the other. So use the universe view to navigate. In the universe view, you cannot make or break a patch. It is simply to give an overview and to help you navigate. Touch the area where you wish to zoom in, and the grid view will return so you can edit the patch again. Notice that one port can be patched to multiple channels, and there is a counter for that. But only one port can be patched to each channel at a time. If you try to make a second patch, you get this patch warning, so you can avoid mistakes. The output patch screen is not so different. There's no A or B patch, but one output channel can be patched to multiple output ports. See the counters in the left column. Again, there's a continuous patch shortcut and the universe view showing you all the possibilities. Scroll down the patch grid and you will see the matrix channels. Then the main stereo outputs. Monitor A and B, cue A and B, and a talkback output. The mon meter outputs will need an explanation. Use those to feed external audio meters pre-fader. So even when the listening level is low, the meters can be clearly visible. Useful for correlation meters, vectorscopes, real-time analyzers, and so on. Moving on to the output port screen. This presents the same information as the output channel patch from a different point of view, showing which source has been linked to each output port. The ports are usefully categorized into tables. And again, the sequential patch will help you get things done quickly here. We'll come back to the recording patch in a later video where I'll explain about setting up a multi-track recording and a virtual sound check. But as a quick guide, the playback in column is only active when virtual sound check is enabled, and it takes over the input patch for the active channels. Recording out is always active under normal conditions and is designed to transfer the inputs to a recording device before any processing is applied. Sub in is a special way to merge the output buses of another mixer with this one. A kind of cascade function, if you will, though without the control linking. You can bring in mix, matrix, main stereo, and cue buses from another mixer to join the same buses of this DM7. And there is an attenuator to adjust the level as much as plus 24 or minus 96 dB. Link to the other mixer via analog or Dante, MADI or AES EBU and expand your capabilities. all the patch settings get stored in the scene memories. So be sure to either store a new scene or update the current one after making significant changes. If you find yourself coming to the patch menu frequently, you could bookmark it to a user-defined key for faster access. Bank A includes some bookmarks by default. Press and hold to set while you're looking at the screen you wish to bookmark. Well, that's enough information for this video. You can be sure to find me again for more training on DM7 series. Don't miss the videos about split mode, assist, and the bus setup. See you again soon.